Stenhouse looking a little loose right behind him in the six there.
See somebody's hand out the window. Looks like Mike Wallace waving at James Buescher behind him.
Oh, look out, Carl Edwards turns, and we've got multi-cars into the wall. Leffler's involved in this. The 62 are gone. The 21 are Boyer. Patrick Shelter involved. The 16 of Colin Brown, the one thing he did not need because he's out of this seat. We've got a car on fire down in the corner of turn one, and it is Mike Wallace. He had a great beginning to this race. There's the damage to Stephen Wallace. There's what's left of the 60 of Carl Edwards.
I saw one car go spinning down and hit the inside wall and then kept going all the way to turn one like the throttle was on.
There's Michael Annette also in the 15.
This is where you don't bump draft right here. You can see Carl Edwards got hit in the rear right there. Oh, my goodness. He got hit by a lot of cars here. It turns into a huge crash. It goes back to a little bit of the inexperience that we were talking about. There are just places on this, with these bumpers not lined up. You see, he just lifted the rear wheels off the ground.
Well, Stenhouse was excused from last week's team meeting. I'm not sure he's going to be excused from this
one. Matt was paying attention because he's doing just exactly what Harvick wanted him to do, and that's put that bumper right to him, try to get him out from here, and then he'll have his shot at winning.
Yeah, Damian Murray had a good run there, and he got a nice push from Brian Vickers, but he pushed him too far.
Shelby, three wide,
and
for second,
out.
Here they go.
The 88 on the high side getting the push from Vickers. Here comes Harvick saying, I remember this guy. I'll dance with him.
Yeah, but don't forget about Boyer on the bottom there.
Vickers right behind him. Boyer now has the 27 as his partner, and Scott Wimmer.
White flag.
Here we go. Harvick in front. Can he make NASCAR history and win both ends of a nationwide Sprint Cup doubleheader in one day?
He's going to have to fight him off from both sides right here. He's got cars coming. Each one.
McMurray with a head of steam.
McMurray, look out. A little contact with a 32. McMurray says, hey, I was in front the last time. You took it away from me earlier today. He's going to try and take it away from me.
Oh, he's hugging the middle. Here's Keselowski.
Got trouble now. Keselowski's got like look out. They're going to go around.
McMurray.
Big crash. And up into the wall. Look out. The caution is out. The race will finish. And it looks like Brad Keselowski is going to get the race win.
Bring it here.
We will check with NASCAR officials because of where the field would be set when the yellow came out. Unofficially, it looks like Brad Keselowski has taken the win. And tough break for Kenny Wallace there.
Well, that's good to see that right there.
That is Dennis Setzer as... Boy, that car is torn up.
They got up in the catch fence. Did his job, though. Put the car right back on the track.
The word from NASCAR is they want to recheck the video and the storylines before they make the official word.
Make a U-turn. Come back around. Nice job, guys. Nice job.
That sounded like the captain, Roger Penske's voice. Brian Scott's car torn up.
Brendan Gaughan
torn up as well.
So they're actually having all these guys turn around on the backstretch and come back.
Yeah, because there is so much damage.
They don't want them running through that accident scene up there. They want to give all of these workers plenty of room. They don't want race cars coming by this. So they're turning them around.
And you can see how much debris is scattered everywhere on this racetrack. Let's go back and take another look and see what happened.
See McMurray trying to get in line right here, right behind Harvick, just not enough room.
Yeah, and he had to check up for just a second because he was on the right rear quarter of Kevin Harvick.
And then once he goes around, the chaos begins. Wow. Look at Setzer.
Wow. Good to see him get out of that car, but that catch fence does its job.
Well, and remember, they raised the catch fence after last year's race here. Also, stretched it out over the racetrack. You're right, it did its job. Another view.
See, right there, Jamie McMurray just trying to get in. He was going to try to get there and push Kevin Harvick.
Just gotta remember, an opening. They're coming to the checkered flag, so they're not going to let off.
Let's go on board with Justin Allgaier. Just listen.
Two outside. Two up, spin in front of you. Watch it. Clear the bottom.
This was the last race for these type cars here, because at Daytona they'll run the new car, but this wasn't how they wanted to send them back.